to break or not to break? That is at least a question. Today, I want to talk about breaking changes in PHP. So recently, people have been growing more and more wary of the upcoming deprecated dynamic properties in PHP 8.2. It's an RFC that splits the PHP community. One group says that dynamic properties are bad and should never be used anyway, and another group prefers not to be bothered with dealing with deprecations if a feature doesn't do any harm. Why deprecate it? Now, the original goal of the RFC was something like this: to prevent mistakes like typos or renames and to make intentional uses explicit. And I mean, I don't oppose those goals, but I also get that some people simply don't think it's worth introducing a breaking change to achieve them. So there was this tweet last week, and I will admit that Taylor's opinion stuck with me for a day or two. He said that programming languages should never have breaking changes. User length packages and software should trend towards less breaking changes over time. Now, I assume Taylor is taking a more extreme stance here, in part because he wants to challenge people to think about it. And I don't blame him for that. I've done the same thing in the past. But still, I definitely don't agree with that opinion. If we were never allowed to introduce breaking changes in a programming language or framework all the same, we would end up with one of three things: a terribly outdated language, because we'd soon run into situations where a breaking change is needed in order to, for example, add new syntax. Or we'd have a terribly slow language, because all the workarounds to keep backwards compatibility are there in code. Or it would be a terribly insecure language, because we wouldn't be able to deprecate insecure parts like PHP did, for example, with mcrypt a couple of years ago. So I get it. I also wouldn't want to deal with boring stuff like deprecations, but I also feel that it's just part of the job. Not everything about coding can be fun all the time. A language needs to evolve, and it sometimes means saying goodbye to some of its parts and all the mess that comes with it. Anyway, that's just my opinion. But what about you? Let me know down in the comments what you think about deprecated dynamic properties. Will they impact your projects? And while you're down there, leave a like and subscribe. You know what to do. And also one more thing, if you liked this video, you might be interested in this one I did about the evolution between PHP 5.6 and PHP 8.2. Make sure to give it a watch and let me know what you think.